الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا حبيبنا مولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وزدنا علما يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك آمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته كيف حالكم؟ I've been banking for a few weeks, so it's good to be back, alhamdulillah. Why does it sound so muffled? It should be better. Okay. Everybody okay? Ya Rabbi. So what's been happening? In class, have you been working hard? Have you been in class? Inshallah. Okay, so Bismillah. We haven't looked at Nahu for a while. Do you remember what you did in the last few lessons? Hopefully you remember Kaan and Inna. Remember Kaan and Inna? Yes. So basically in the last few lessons we did Ismu kana, khabru kana, ismu inna, khabru inna. How do I say the man was tall? Tawil is tall. How do I say the man was tall? Kana rajulu tawi. طويلا كان الرجل طويلا I don't say indeed the man is tall إن الرجل طويل إن الرجل طويل Okay So if you're going to summarize in your mind inshallah you're going to realize that you have six things that are always in raf'un Let's name them Bismillah But the first thing you learned in first year about the thing is in Raf'un? Fa'il. Like you say, Nasara al-Rajuluh. So the Fa'il number one is always in Raf'un. What's the second thing you learned in first year? No, what's the second thing you learned in the second Jumla in first year? Mubtada and Khabar. So Mubtada al-Rajuluh Tawilun Khabar is tall. So those are three things now in Raf'un. Fa'il is always in Raf'un. Mubtada is always in Raf'un. Khabar is always in Raf'un. Now you're going to add three things this year. What's the third, the next one? Instead of Fa'il now, we have Nusira al-Waladu Na'ibul Fa'il. Alright, we did listen long once upon a time. We did a lesson on Na'ibul Fa'il, remember? Nusira al-Waladu. The boy was helped. So Na'ibul Fa'il is number four. And the last two is what? Ismu kana, kana rajulu tawilan and khabru inna, inna rajula tawilun. Can you in your mind can you see those six things? So fa'il, mubtada khabr, that's on first year. In second year, we did three more now. Na'ibul fa'il. When you have what do you call that verb again now? A majhool verb. You have na'ibul fa'il. And the last two, it's easy because we did now. Kana and inna. Ismu kana and khabru inna. If you get confused about those things, it's okay. You just carry on. If you get confused, you just carry on. And that's it. We'll repeat and repeat, eventually it'll come. But if it doesn't come also, it's okay. You just bismillah. You don't know, you're not going to know everything. So what I'm saying is don't get too stressed. We're going to go through everything inshallah, but don't get too stressed because it gets a lot. Because now we finish with Rahman, right? But only six things are always in Rahman. Then there's only two things always in Jarun. What are the two things always in jar? From first year? Ismu majrur is always in jar and? Mudaf like this. Only two things Arabic is always in jar. So six raf'un, two jar'un. The biggest category is the middle one is nasbun. Okay, so we can do all the nasbun things. And last year I only learned one nasbun thing, which is what? Maf'ulun bihi. So now today, not today, we're going to start with another 9 or 10 more inshallah. Okay, nasbun things. Okay, so do you have the handouts there? Okay, so the first one says what? I don't know what's your first and my first. They're numbered. But all of these here, maf'ul, mutlaq, ismu la nafidin lil jins, maf'ulun li ajlihi, maf'ulun lahu, al-badal. Okay, badal's on nasb. Where's the rest? Is it all? Oh, we're double-sided. Oh, double-sided also. Tamyiz, ismu munada, hal. Okay, there are lots of stuff now, eh? What's it? What number? Yeah, we don't confine ourselves to numbers here. Yeah. So we'll do it one by one, inshallah. One by one we'll do it. Yeah. But to make it easier for you, nasbun things just mainly fill in details. Nasbun things just fill in details. So before I start, let me give you an example on the board and some details quickly. Like if I say, okay, I say no. Yeah, is it good? Okay, so let me go back to the first the jumlas, right? Don't pull this thing here. The jumlas. So with the raf'un things, a lot of like, it's the core stuff in raf'un. What do you mean the core stuff? Like there's a verb, and who did the action? That's the fa'il. Or there's a mubtada, the focus, and give me news, and that's the mubtada and the khabar. So when we come to nasbun things, it asks you, for example, where did the action occur? Was it sabahan, in the morning, masa'an, in the evening, or how long did it occur for? How long did it occur for? Sa'atan, and so on. Or it's going to ask you, not where, it's when. It's also going to ask you, where. It's going to ask you, how did the action occur? It's going to ask you, what was the condition of like the doer and the done upon. Okay, so like just details. So for example, if I say in Arabic, Kataba Zaidun, what's the meaning of that? Zaid wrote. But if I say Kataba Zaidun Sa'atan, Sa'a means an hour. What does it mean? Zaid wrote for an hour. So the Sa'atan is adding you detail about how long he wrote. You with me? But if I say Kataba Zaidun Sabahan, Sabah means morning. What does it mean? So he wrote in the morning, so he's telling you when he wrote. Or I can say, Kataba Zaidun Amam al Ustad. Amam means what? In front of the teacher. So what's he doing now? Showing you where he wrote. So asking you when he wrote, where he wrote. If I say كتب زيد جالسا, جالسا means to sit. So جالسا means what? Is زيد wrote جالسا sitting. Or كتب زيد قائما, زيد wrote standing. So telling you how he wrote and the حال he wrote and so on. So these are gonna answer questions that, like for example, I say ضرب الرجل الولد ضربا شديدا. ضرب means what? Hit الرجل الولد. The man hit the boy ضربا شديدا. A severe beating. Can he telling you what? How was the verb? What type of verb was it? How was the verb done? We'll come to the English afterwards, inshallah. So I'm telling you how was the verb done. So this is what I mean by details. I just add, giving you extra information about the sentence. For example, if I can say Zaid wrote, I can ask where he wrote, when he wrote, how he wrote, how was his condition, what is the condition of the writing. Yeah, there's many questions I can ask, and the nas things just add all those details in. Okay, so we're going to go through one by one per week. But all we're doing is just adding details. Okay, we're adding details to a sentence. Because you know the basic sentence, right? There's only jumatul fi'liya, jumatul ismiya. And the fi'liya only has fi'l fa'il maf'ul. That's the core of it. The rest is details. And the jumatul ismiya just has muhtara khabr. You can add inna and kana before it, like, as we learned. But the rest is all details. So the rest of the things we're doing are going to be like details about the sentence. So we can start with one today, inshallah. Let's start with, let me just choose one for you. It's a nice one to start with. Not Mahmoud Lok, Tamiz. Let's start with, let me see what you have. Had. So it's had. حال, yeah. So us find the sheet that says حال on top. You can put number one there. You can confine yourself to a number and say one. You can put the one there now, okay? So you can put the title also now. You can add all the nice things there. Okay, so the way the format works is I generally kept the explanation very short and the rest is just examples. So let's read together, inshallah. The hal will be an ism. So the hal is not a fi'l or a harf, it's an ism. Which will be in nasb and nakira. Those words make sense for you? Ism, which will be in nasb and will be in nakira. In other words, there's no al. And why do we have this ism as nasb and nakira? The underlying parts of the main thing. It describes the condition, the hal, the condition of either the subject, fa'il, du'a, or the object, maf'ulun bihi, done upon, at the time of the verb. Okay. In other words, it answers the question to how or what is the condition of the du'a or the done upon at the time of the verb. So that sounds very unclear until you go through some examples. Just go through some examples and it will become much clearer, inshallah. Allah says here, وَنَحْشُرُهُمْ. Translate. What's نَحْشُرُ? حَشَرَ means together. So نَحْشُرُهُمْ. And we, Allah, we will gather them يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. So we're not there yet, but can you just take a mental note and see it's yawma in nasb. You know why? Because it's telling you when. We shall come to the lesson later on, but I'm just saying in the meantime, just take a mental note that's saying yawma because it's ma, because it's telling you when. Detail. And we will gather them on the day of Qiyamah, ala, upon wujuhihim, upon their faces. Umyan. In the Umyan. Wa bukman. Wa summan. You probably heard it before. Umyun, bukmun, summun. So which one is which? That's the problem. I'll make it easy for you. Umyan starts with the ayn. And the ayn is also an eye. So umyan means blind. I can't even remember it because it's difficult to think now what is which one. Umyan means blind. And then, or bookman means what? Yeah, we'll rather say mute. Mute. I think dumb is now not politically correct. I know you grew up with dumb, but now I think it's mute. Oh, I don't know, vocally challenged. So, mute, I think mute is the more acceptable term. I'm not sure, they keep changing. But I think mute now is the more acceptable term. Next one, summan. Deaf, unable to hear. Deaf. Okay. So let's leave bookman and summan for now. What question is the word umyan answering in a sentence? Or what detail is giving you? The condition of who? So look at yourselves, look at the first verb, right? Nahshuruhum. There's two people in that verb, two entities. The one entity is the nahnu referring to Allah. And the whom is mankind. So there's two entities. There's a doer and a done upon in that sentence. So is umyan describing the condition of the doer or done upon? The whom, the done upon. Okay, so can you see what question is umyan answering? Umyan is answering the question is how, what will the condition be of the people at the time of the verb? You with me? They're not blind now, but I'll say at the time of the verb. You with me? When that verb is going to happen, Allah is telling you what the condition of the people is going to be. وَنَحْشُرُهُمْ And we, Allah, we will gather them. يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَلَىٰ وُجُوهِمْ On the day of judgment, upon their faces. And what will their condition be at the time of the verb? It will be umyan. It will be umyan. And the wa and the wa is obviously linked to all linked to umyan. So what do we call it umyan? We call it umyan hal. And what hal is the hal in? That hal is in nasb. So strange because it's also called, like you call something fa'il, you call something maf'ulun bihi, you call something mubtada khabar, you call this thing hal. Right? The name of it's called hal. And the hal also obviously has a hal, which is what? Nasb. And always nakira also. Nasb and nakira. Next one. Rabbirhamhuma. Rabbi means what? My Lord. Normally actually means, yeah, Rabbi, like, oh my Lord, it's a dua. Rabbi, oh my Lord. Irhamhuma. Irham, what irham? It's the amr, it's a command, for dua. Oh Allah, you have mercy on huma. What's huma? How many people is Huma? Huma is two people. Oh Allah have mercy on the two of them, referring to parents. Kama, as how Rabbayani Rabba, as they have raised me Saghiran. They have raised me, in which hal was I? When I was small, when I was a baby. Because obviously your parents don't really raise you when you're now 20, 30, 40 years old. So you're talking about raising when you were small. Okay, so which word do you think is the hal there? So Saghiran is the hal. What question is answering? What was the condition, my condition, when what happened? When they raised me. When they raised me, what was my condition? Okay, next one. So again, the Rabbayani. Rabba is a verb, right? Rabba is a verb. It means to raise, to give tarbiyah, to raise nurture someone. Rabbaya means that alif there refers to two people. So the alif there is actually the fa'il. It's difficult to see, but the alif there is a fa'il and the ni is the me. Is the saghiran speaking about the condition of the parents or the condition of the children? Of the ni of the children, the danapan, not the doer. Okay. Last one I'll give you now is, now I'll give you one with the conditions of the doer. Next one. Thumma. Then. Ja'alna. We will make. We made this, but for the future we will make. Lahu. For him, Jahannama. We will make for him, hellfire. Yaslaha. Yasla means to enter, enter means to burn. He will enter and he will burn it. So yasla is a verb. What is the doer for the verb? It is the huwa inside. He will enter. What's the ha going back to? The ha is going back to Jahannam. You will enter what? You will enter it, Jahannam. Okay. Madhmuman madhura. Madhmum means someone who is like blamed. Someone who is criticized. Dham is to find like censure. Find displeasure. To criticize, to blame someone. Madhura, I think madhura means someone who is like, I think someone who's like chased, like despised, chased, I must double check, but I think it means despised, someone who's like chased away basically. I was speaking about shaitan. So, those two words there, madhmuma and madhura, they're both nas, nakira. What are they answering in the question? Of who? Of him, referring to shaitan. The condition of yaslaha, that ye shaitan, he will enter it, Jahannam what? But then Allah answers another question, in what hal, not like noble, or as a leader, or strong, he will enter Jahannam madhmuman. Someone will be blamed, someone will be criticized, madhura, someone will be despised, or will be like chased away. Because all people hate him because he's the one who misled them. You with me? So can you see here, Allah is saying that madhmum and madhur is the hal of who? The dua danapan? Yasla, who is the dua of yasla? Who is going to enter? Huwa. So of the dua yasla, he's going to enter. So yasla is the verb. Yasla is the verb, means to enter, to burn. Who's going to enter, going to burn? The huwa inside there. You with me? So it's showing you the condition of the huwa inside there. He will enter her, it Jahannam, and what will his be condition be at the time of the verb? His condition will be madhmuman madhura. Okay. Any questions on it? I don't know all of the things because it's for homework actually. I just want to give you three examples just to discuss. Let's read again one more time, inshallah, from the beginning. So, the hal, this thing is called hal. Like something is called maf'ul bi fa'il, this thing is called hal. So, the hal will be an ism which will be in nasb and nakira. So, it's easy to see it will be nasb nakira. But the main thing in terms of why it's nasb nakira is because it describes the condition, the hal, of either the subject or the object. In other words, the condition of someone in the sentence. The condition of someone in the sentence at the time of the verb. For example, if I say a simple thing, I say, Ja'a Zaydun Rakiban. What does Ja'a mean? To come, to arrive. Who arrived? Zayd arrived. Rakiban. Rakiban means to ride. So Zayd arrived what? Rakiban. He arrived riding. What is not mashi and walking? He ride Rakiban riding. What is the Rakiban answering? Which question? How or what was the hal of Zayd at the time of the verb? You with me? I'm just answering the hal of him at the time of the verb. So this general always hal, it's at the time of the verb, what was his hal. So all of these are examples, all of these have a hal in it. So your homework is to translate it. This is the Quran reference. Is to find out the vocab, translate it, and identify the hal, and make sure you understand how the hal is answering the question of how was the person's condition at the time of the verb. Okay, that's it. Is it? You must just get used to it. You must get used to it. So I'll keep this as short as possible, short explanation, some examples, just get used to it, inshallah. What I'm saying is, don't stress about these things. I'm going to take you through all the nahu things like this, inshallah. So you'll cover all the things, but you'll practice as you go through the Quran. Okay, but I just want to get through all of them, so you at least finish all of the nahu concepts. Okay. Good. If you have any suggestions, you're welcome to share with me. If you want to, inshallah.